So this is the foam roller. You start off seated on the roller, and basically you use your hands to help push it forward a little bit, make sure it rolls as you move so you don't just slide down it. And you're gonna work its way down, and you'll get to a point where you start to tilt your head back, keep your butt off the ground as you walk forward, and roll all the way up until you feel it touch your head, and you walk back down. Now you're gonna find certain points where you feel pressure, where it feels like it's gonna pop or release. When you hit those points, cross your arms, lift your elbows up and down, back and forth across that spot. It'll help move that area and hopefully release. You can also bend to the left and the right and work back and forth on top of that area. Watch for your clothes to roll into the bowl, into the roller. Basically, you want to do three passes from the top of your back to the bottom and try to release the pressure the best you can. And mine just popped and released right there. And this will help decrease the pressure in your spine on a daily basis. It builds up naturally on its own from gravity, weight, the way we sleep and eat, sit on the chair. Now, some more things to do here. Bring your elbows together and lean to the side a little bit and roll across your rib cage to release pressure in your ribs back and forth the same way, and go to both sides. If you have pain between your shoulder blades, it's a great way to get your shoulder blade out of the way so you can roll on top of it. Like so. Now, a little more advanced move. If you have pain in your calves or your feet, to roll your calves, cross your ankles, lift your butt off the ground, use your hands to walk down. If you have bad wrists, you can't do this. You have to sit on your butt and just kind of roll it back and forth like this if you have bad wrists. But if you can support your weight on your hands, roll back and forth on your heels, switch sides, run up and down your calves. If you have problems with tight hamstrings, put it underneath your thigh, point your bottom foot towards 10 o'clock on the left side of the room in front of you, on the left side of the wall, and roll back and forth like this, and then do the other side. Now you're pointing at 2 o'clock. You can use the wall if you need to get across there, but you'll feel when you get across a certain point in your side of your leg where the tension is, you'll feel where it hurts. Roll across on top of that area and release some of that pressure. Now to do the front of your legs, flip over. I call this the Spider-Man. You act like your Spider-Man claw on the wall. Put your roller down against your right knee. Put your left hand and your left leg forward. Extend your leg and roll back and forth like this, keeping your foot off the ground, pumping your chest up and down as you roll in and out. Then move a little bit further up so the roller goes down towards your knee. Up and down like this. This is the Spider-Man. You can also point your toe to your left, get the outside of the front of your calf, keep your toe off the ground, and then point the other direction and get the inside of your thigh. You can go up all the way, check and make sure there's no areas of pain. And you do the same thing on the other side. So you put it against your left knee, put your right knee and your right hand forward, and roll the same. You can increase the tension on your knee by bringing your heel closer to your hip, like so. Just like that.